About changing one's mind. Today's gospel, Jesus says a parable to the Pharisees. And Jesus says, a man had two sons, and he came to the first and said, Son, go out and work in the vineyard today. He said in reply, I will not, but afterwards changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, Yes, sir, but did not go. But after that, Jesus does not tell them why the first son changed his mind. Possibly he feared his father, or his conscience bothered him, or just he did it out of love. But the second reading, the Paul's letter to Philippians, he gives us some clue why. The second reading says, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found himself in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Even though Jesus didn't tell them why, but Jesus showed why. Because he wanted to follow the Father's will in humility. I want to talk about the humility a little bit today. Because as a caption, we know it is how it's difficult to be obedient to our superior or even to our brothers. It requires lots of humility, not only love. Because we need to put ourselves down and just follow the order. But sometimes we struggle because we believe our decision is better than yours. But it is true that we do it in many times in humility. I want to say about my experience a little bit. Some moment I was very unhappy with the campus life. Because I need to be very honest, because when was something going on, I used to blame brothers. This is happening to me because this brother. I like this brother because it causes all the problems. But this is, I think, it is our human nature. By nature, we cannot accept our weakness, our mistake. Even first reading in Ezekiel says, the Israelites blame God. He says, the Lord's way is not fair. Right? So it is very hard to accept our weakness. I just let's tell you a story about a guardian. Because I love his story, but because he addressed his mistake in public, I value a lot about his announcing his mistake. During his novitiate year, he was ironing his clothes, but in some reason, the iron dropped. I think, I don't know exactly if I'm not correct, he can tell us the correct stories, but I hope it was not brand new carpet. But there is exactly the iron shape, right? Black, dark brown. And then he was really embarrassed, but later his guardian found out. And they asked, hey, what happened? And then it was very hard for him to acknowledge his mistake. And said, he just said he was blaming the iron. The iron dropped. Right? You cannot move by yourself, it's obvious. But like that, I was, it is very, when I was blaming other people, other brothers, the problem is brother. It is very hard to live with the brothers in community because anger, frustration grows day by day and just unhappy. But like, I guess like, it has been a long process for me, but at some moment, I was looking in the problem in by myself, in my mind, what all the problem, what is coming, all the problems. I was looking. I was asking God, what is happening to me? And I slowly, you know, realized that all the problem was actually in here. And it is very tough, actually. It is very hard for me to accept my weakness and my mistake. And actually, it was me, Thomas Sowell, was the cause of all the problems. But actually, I realized I had to accept. But brothers, even though it is tough, it is a long process, I found great joy in there. Because a couple of things I can mention it. First, when I accept my weakness and also my loneliness, first I found that all the brothers are really nice brothers actually. There are really nice and there are kinds of holy brothers. I began valuing all their talents and their how much they take care of each other and they'll try to follow our Lord Jesus Christ. And it was very nice, actually, it was a great turning point in my life as captain. Second thing, I really appreciate it because what I really greatly value is even though in my loneliness, my weakness, I found God still loved me. It was an amazing experience because I felt like, you know, I'm kind of a, oh my goodness, I'm a terrible person, you know. I deserve nothing, but still, I found He still loves me. Always. So it brought me to a deeper relationship and deeper love toward God. So it helped my captain life a lot. So like this, happiness is not outside brothers. It is not dependent on what brothers do to you or what is happening to me. Actually, all happiness is in our mind.